When Alycia Gillaspie was just 12 years old, she threaded her mom's sewing machine with no problem.
So at 12 years old, I got my first machine.
She taught herself how to make prom dresses and took an interest in sculpture.
I think that is what helped lead me into doing design and especially apparel, because it's like a human, it's like a sculpture on a human.
She was top of her high school class in sewing.
It was at that point that I realized I really had a talent or a skill.
Gillaspie entered MTSU in apparel design within the textile merchandising and design major. Recently, Project OR, Outdoor Retailing, contacted 5 universities, including MTSU, looking for talent.
They chose me over all the other students.
Gillaspie and 4 other national top competitors were limited to 48 hours to create a backcountry ski jacket.
And only the vendors and the people who created the brief know what the brief is until 10 a.m. on day one. After we get the brief, we're given time to about 3 hours to come up with a concept and do a preliminary sketch and come up with an idea, which is no time at all to even figure out what you're doing, especially if you've never skied before.
All the competitors worked from the exact same brief in the same room.
Well, to start out with, the challenge was figuring out what I was making, because the brief actually says a convertible women's backcountry ski / snow jacket with an ear covering accessory. So I had to read it about 6 times to break it down, and I also had to include the ear covering accessory, some sort of hat or headband or something, and so that was probably the first challenge.
The next challenge was figuring out what she could do in the 48-hour time frame without sleep, no doubt.
I chose to do just enough design elements that I thought I would have time to completely complete, to sew and finish all the way until it was done. There's nothing more you can do with it.
Even though it wasn't required, she also made it finished on the inside.
And I think that's really what made a difference for me, was being able to sew it and construct it really well.
The double hood feature enables the skier to fit the larger outer shell hood over a helmet.
I made a hood that was separate from the collar but still attached to the jacket, so the collar could be pulled up around the face without having the hood on, and then the hood would come up and over the helmet. Then it would have a bungee cord system inside it where you pull the bungee and it tightens down on the helmet.
Her design was unique because rather than a bungee system in the back and over the head, she added a unique touch.
I tried to incorporate it by going up from one side, across the back, up over the head, across the back again, and then down the other side. So you pull here, and it pulls down, back, and down all at once.
The rather complex design did the trick, despite some initial reservations on the part of judges.
Something along the lines of, we weren't sure how she was going to do, because during her first presentation, there was a lot of grief from us. We didn't really see where she was going and didn't think she had the potential, but once we saw her garment, we saw the competition had really been bumped up, and so congratulations, Alycia, and I about cried, but I was shocked. I could have sworn that the girl who made runner-up won. All I could do was, like, hold my composure so that I didn't cry on camera.